Welcome, Butte County and all of Northern California, to TUBE-A-THON, a virtual fundraiser for the Butte County Democrats. My name is Joe Hilsee, and I'm absolutely pleased to be your host for this wonderful event that we have planned for you today. Now, we have an array of musical talent that's going to entertain you, and we have some very special guests who are going to fill you in on issues that are important to them and that are important to you as well. Now, as all of you know, COVID-19 has left us all sheltering in place. Normally, this time of year, we'd be gathering in event halls throughout the county, and we'd be celebrating what it is to be a Democrat, and we'd be planning this important election that's coming up in November. But we can't do that. So we've created this for you, a virtual environment where we can do that same thing. So this is our opportunity for us to meet with you. It's our opportunity to meet the candidates and allow them to talk to you. And in a very special way, they're going to be talking to you not from a stage, talking from a microphone in some event hall. They're going to be talking to you from their own homes, directly into your home. It's a unique experience and one that's created out of this environment that we're in right now. So the aim of this telethon is to create some funds, is for you to have the opportunity to donate to the Democratic Party to help fund the headquarters in Oroville and in Chico, and to help fund those candidates who are running for positions at the city, county, and state level. All of the donations that come in today, all of the donations are staying right here in Butte County, staying right here with the local Democratic Party, which is going to be important in creating our communities as we go forward. So, below me, you're going to see a Act Blue button. It's an Act Blue link. Now, this link was created specifically for this event right now. You can click on that at any time, and you can donate any amount of money that you see fit to the Butte County Democratic Party at any time during this event. Now, if you're not comfortable with that, there's going to be a phone number that scrolls across the bottom periodically. You can pick up the phone at any time. We've got some people who are eager to talk to you on the phone, and they'll take your information there as well. Now, we have a wonderful list of people who are going to be talking to you. People are going to be performing for you today, so I want to get right into it. So our first guest today, many of you know him, many of you respect him. He's an activist and a community leader from Oroville. It's the pastor, Kevin Thompson.
With everything that's going on in our world today, certainly with the recent George Floyd's death, it's become sickeningly and familiar, you know, with many of us. So we're looking for candidates, those that's going to pick up and carry the banner and deal with the systemic racism problems that we have in our communities. This is just one thing. And I guess Donna Edwards said it a lot better than I could. And she said something to this effect. I do not know a Black family that does not have a story. The internet is filled with accounts of driving and walking and shopping and running and eating while Black. How many stories can we count in just the past 10 years of Black people doing ordinary things that result in their harassment, detention, restraints, and even death? George Floyd is the latest in two of the long list of Black men and women who have died at the hands of white police officers. Ahmaud Arbery was jogging when a neighborhood vigilante chased him down and shot and killed him. Christian Cooper was simply bird watching in New York Central Park when a white woman walking her dog tried to weaponize 911 to bring law enforcement to bear on a Black person. 12-year-old Tamara Rice was killed by police while playing in a playground near his home in Cleveland. Trayvon Martin, we all remember him, was shot and killed while walking with a bag of Skittles and an iced tea by an appointed neighborhood outlook group in Florida. Sadly for Black people, no traffic stop is routine. School cafeteria worker Philando Castile was shot and killed during the stop in Minnesota with his girlfriend's 4-year-old daughter in the back seat. He wasn't even driving. Sandra Bland was detained following an alleged unsafe lane change near Houston and was later found hanging dead in her jail cell. How about being at home? Emergency medical technician Breonna Taylor was shot at least 8 times by police officers who kicked in her Louisville apartment door. pre-med graduate Athea Jackson was shot and killed while babysitting her nephew in her mother's home. Accountant Batham Jean was shot and killed in his Dallas home after a day at work. For black people, even relatively minor infractions resulted in an encounter with the police and
trio,
to their death.
But we're going to press on.
Was killed by just simply
specializing in music in the 1920s
selling loose
and
cigarettes on the street in Staten Island. Freddie Gray died in the back of a Baltimore police van after he was found to be in possession of a knife. We may not be able to march with you peacefully in Minneapolis, but you need to know that we are with you in spirit. And with that, we just want to know, and it goes on, that in a time and the day that we're living in now, we need leaders that's going to stand up for all people. The person that we have in the White House now, he's against minorities, we know that, but he's against white children too. He's given the okay to gas them and to harm them and beat them with batons and other things. And we need to make sure that when 2020's election come around on the 3rd, that he is voted out, and immediately on the 4th, we're believing that the Republican Party, as we know it, it wouldn't even be in existence anymore because of how they treated the American people. So we just want to have you join in with us, not just at the national level, but also at the state level and your local level. Vote your city council, vote your mayors. They have the power to hire police chiefs. And if they don't have our best interests at hand, we're just hoping and praying that we can just bombard the polls and vote. Vote is our medicine. In many cases, you go to your doctor. The doctor prescribe a medication for you. You take that medication faithfully. You keep taking it. You take it day in and day out. And after a while, the medication is going to get to the condition. So our vote is our medication. So continue to vote. It might be slow, but if we stay faithful and we vote, I guarantee you that the vote is going to get to the conditions that we're in our community today. So I just want to tip my hat to each and every one of you once again and just say, join with us in this tube-a-thon with the Butte County Democrats. Support us that we get our headquarters open, that we might get out and engage individuals in our community. So once again, we just want to say thank you. And we're asking you, just whatever you do, keep the faith. Let's move on. God bless you, Pastor Kevin.
Thank you so much, Pastor Kevin, for that powerful and passionate plea. All of you, these are important times. So please donate that Act Live button right below you. You can donate anytime during this telecast there. Or call that number that's below the screen as well. Next up, I want to get to a musical guest. They're well-known performers throughout venues throughout Chico, and they've got a unique blend of gypsy, jazz, and swing music. Please welcome to the program, Hot Potato.
Hello there, folks. We usually perform as a trio, but our bass player is making a sandwich right now. So we'll continue as Gordy and Pamela. We specialize in music in the 1920s and 30s. Here's what they were dancing to in 1920.
Church bells chime. Will it be Go Democrats.
Thank you so much, Hot Potato. That was fantastic. Bye-bye. So when our next speaker first taught a course in homelessness at Chico State, she and her students spent 48 hours on the streets of the nation's capital. Experiences like these are important for all of the students and for all of us to help express our views. And so I'd like to welcome to the program the mayor of Chico, Ann Schwab.
Thank you so much for having me. The experience that I shared with the students sleeping on the streets for 48 hours was transformative. It completely changed the way I view homelessness, and it completely changed my lens on how we need to address problems in our community. Rather than going after social services, what we need to do is real social change. We have big problems in front of us: homelessness, climate change, COVID-19, racial injustice, police reforms, poverty. These are issues that need to be addressed systematically and not just glossed over. We have a lot of work to do, and Democrats can do that. We're looking for solutions, even in the middle of a crisis. And one solution that I've been working on is jobs, bringing green jobs to our community, jobs that bring with them equity, living wage, employers who understand that daycare and health care are needed in our community by our workers, those that respect our workers. They'd be part of the solution and work with our natural resources and the talents that we have here. I've been working with the university and looking at ways how we can bring businesses to our area and become incubators for good green jobs in our community. We learned from COVID-19, we can't put all of our eggs in one basket, in the university basket, and now we are working together to find solutions. Through the trials that we have had in the last 3 years, one thing that we have learned is that we are resilient. We are Butte strong. We are Democrats, and we can work on this together. Thank you so much for listening today, donating. Remember to click on the link for Act Blue. Donate, support Democrats so that we can bring about systematic change that we so desperately need. Thank you for viewing. It's been great to connect with you. Until we can meet again in person, please take good care of yourselves. Bye.
Thank you so much, Anne, for those words. Some exciting news. We're less than 15 minutes into this telethon. We've raised almost $1,000 already. Now, this is important because all of the money that we raise here, every single dime, is going to be staying here locally in Butte County to help the headquarters in Oroville and Chico, help those candidates who are running for offices at the city, at the state level. So keep that money coming in, keep the donations, because these are the offices, those that are closest to us. They're the offices that most directly influence our communities. And so hit that Act Live button, please, or call that number. So we've got another musical guest up, and I'm quite excited to introduce these people to you. A lot of you have seen them. This is a duo. They're from a larger band, but they're going to be performing as a duo. I want to welcome now Cat and Coot from the Mystic Roots.
Hey, how's it going, everybody? So happy to be here. Again, I am Coot Dog.
And I am Kat, or Catherine.
And we are from the Mystic Roots. We're accompanied right now by a little baby duet. It's going to sit in my lap while we play. Happy to be here to support the Butte Democrats. Please, everyone who's watching, donate below. There's a link for the Act Blue below. Donate to the Democrats. We need some change this election, and we're very excited to play some music for you guys. Tell us what song we got today.
Absolutely. We're going to do a song called Ready For It. It's about music festivals, and I know we could all use some of those in our lives right now. But until then, we will bring you there. Love you, Chico. Well, I've been working every day, now I need a break. Wishing that somebody would come take me away to a special party where everyone knows. Feeling the
up to the sound of the music playing in the warm sunlight. Smile on my face, cause I'm loving these vibes. Hold me tight, cause it feels so right. Don't think of tomorrow, let's just live for tonight.
We are one, we don't fight. So much love, so much
time. And I wanna know where we can go. Take me, oh yeah, to the festival. Oh, 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 oh. I'm ready for it. Oh, 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 oh. I'm so ready for it. Oh, 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 oh.
After me wait all year, festival time come up. Family time, yes, the whole crew turn up. High grade and on my palm, we are crumb up. EDH burn up till the sunshine come up. High pressure's got the bag and sweet back at it. No wheezy's up with Chico if you want to get tatted. Summer festivals, I can't get enough, but just rage. Cali roots, summer voice sounds rough. 3 days getting blazed out under the sun. No stress, so blessed, everybody is one. I'm sipping the Sierra cause I'm repping Chico. To the river on the main stage, where you want to go? I'm taking in the energy that they're giving now.
Can you feel us now?
You should put away your phone because we're living in the now. Rhythm and the vibe gets you higher than the roll. Feel us so alive, catch a fire in the moon. All kind of beat bumping in the dance, all roots, trap, hip hop, man, I'm loving it all.
Oh, 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 I'm ready for it. Oh, 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 I'm so ready for it.
Oh,
I wanna know.
Thank you, Butte Dems. So happy to be here with you guys. Please donate below, Act Blue. Vote for change. Get some great candidates in office this fall. We love you so much.
Love you.
Oh, Cat and Coot. That was one of the cutest things I think I've ever seen. That was fantastic. Thank you so much for joining us. I've got some exciting news, everyone. We're less than 20 minutes into this. We've already raised over $1,500. Which is amazing, and that is why we're doing this. Our next guest, I want to get right into it, is a born in Chico, was graduated from Chico State, and I know that she is one of the biggest advocates of the arts in Butte County that I've ever met, and it is my pleasure to introduce to you Butte County Supervisor from the 2nd District, Debra Lucero.
Hi, hello there. It's great to be with everyone. This is so exciting. I love when we are utilizing technology to its fullest. So thanks. I'm here to talk about voting because, as you know, we have been out on the streets for the last 10 days. And the next thing that we want to do is to get into the ballot box and vote. And this year, it's going to be easier than ever before. And that's because every single person in Butte County has already received, well, will be receiving a ballot. California is the first state to specifically move to sending everybody a ballot in the mail. So there is no excuse to not vote. And that's how we make our voices heard, to vote. There are more Democrats in Butte County than there are Republicans, and yet we're still losing seats. That shouldn't happen. We should be winning seats. We know that we have a wonderful platform. We're inclusive. We are for the people. And so as Democrats, we need to get out there and encourage other folks to vote. The last voting round in the primary, it was the largest turnout in California history. And it was also the largest turnout in Butte County's history. 13 of 15 counties that went to an all mail-in ballot voting option, which, by the way, our own president is discounting, is it's one of the most secure ways to vote. 13 of 15 counties in California exceeded with record turnout rates. So the new way of looking at voting in California is the percentage of eligible voting age population. And last time around, 38.4% of eligible voting age population turned out. That means, just think if we could get 50%, and that's only 50%. It was higher in Butte County. It was the highest that we had ever had. And you know what's making the difference? People of color and young people. They are actually registering in larger numbers than any other groups of people, but we're still not getting them to vote. So if you're out there and you're hearing my voice, please vote. You're our future. You're our now. We need you. We need you to be a part of democracy, this great experiment that seemingly right now is in turmoil, but we can win by you casting your vote. We can win this by you becoming part of the race. This is for our democracy. This is for Butte County. And Butte County is the heart of the North State. We can do this, and I believe that the way Butte County goes, so goes the North State. So come on, Dems, let's do it. Let's do this. Remember to vote with your money too, and please donate at the link below. Thank you so much.
Debra, thank you so much. And that's absolutely important. What she says is absolutely right. The most important aspect of the election is voting, actually going out and voting and casting that ballot so that you can get the people in the office that mean the same thing as you do, that care about the issues that you care about. So I'm happy to report to you, we're already up to $1,600 and that figure keeps going up and we're so pleased with what's going on. So I want to introduce to you another musician. You've heard this person in many, many bands throughout Butte County over the years. And lately he's been duetting with a mandolin player, Diane Garner. These are two tried and true Democrats here in Butte County. Ladies and gentlemen, Stevie Cook and Diane Garner.
Hey, thanks everybody for being here. And like everybody said, click that Act Blue button and donate to the local party and let's support our candidates and get everybody in office.
So this is a song I wrote with my friend Bruce Otway, and it's on our seemingly endless need to consume everything. Well, too much is just enough. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
that you'll never give up on me. Fill that empty place inside, crying to the mountain. Wine is flowing, pouring in the sea. No matter how much I drink, not too much of me. Someone's out there starving, I hear a scream of me. I come from the land of too much is just enough. I come from the land of too much, just enough.
Thanks so much.
Hello, everyone. My name is Janet Goodson, and I am a councilwoman in the city of Oroville and the interim acting president of the NAACP Butte County Local Chapter 1029. Currently, as a nation, we are facing one of the most challenging times in our nation, a time in our democracy where systemic racism continues to threaten African American lives. We are witnessing protests on a national and global level, and we have come to the end of the road where we must look squarely into the face of institutional racism and fight to eradicate the policing policies that do not value the preservation of human life. There needs to be a restructuring of the judicial system and a determined all-out effort to vote those out who do not uphold the constitutional rights of we, the people. The Democratic Party has been a friend and a supporter of the NAACP since its conception in 1909. I am asking you to join with me in the best way that I know how to make a donation and give back to the Democratic Party that continues to support equal opportunity and advancement for all. Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone, to Tubing with the Democrats, a virtual live fundraiser for the Butte County Democratic Party. Want to give you an update on what's coming in. We're at $2,200 and it's climbing. This is really going well, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for donating. Keep going. I want to introduce you to another musical guest. These guys, they just released their debut album, Anywhere You Take Me, last month. Here they are with an original song about the summer in the North State. It's my pleasure to introduce to you some very good friends of mine, Betten Ruttenberg and Samantha Francis, better known to everyone else as the Bidwells.
Thank you so much, Joe. We're so excited to be here and to help support this wonderful cause.
We're excited to play a song for you. And while we're doing that, we'd like to encourage everyone watching to follow the link below, the Act Blue link, and make sure you're donating to this very worthy cause. It's gonna help to enact the change we wanna see in this community and all sorts of positive change that this event is promoting. So this song was written about our hometown of Chico. It's a nostalgic love note to my hometown. I miss the summers in my hometown, when everything would slow down and the trees would lend relief from the heat of the sun, with shade enough for everyone. I miss the summers in my hometown, when the sun would go down, the sky would glow, it'd envy us below, and I miss it so. Oh, oh, we would drive with windows down, feel the air move.
my family. Wanna see them constantly. And I remember why I left, but I don't know why I stayed. And you couldn't call it theft, cause the time I lost I gave. And it's certainly nice to know that I can go. And it's certainly nice to know that I can go. I miss the winters back where I'm from, cause I never felt so lonesome. Listening to the rhythm as the rain would fall. Man, I miss it all. Certainly nice to know that I can go. And it's certainly nice to know that I can go. Oh, 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 we would drive with windows down, feel the air move. Wanna see them constantly until they're sick of me. Well, I remember why I left, but I don't know why I stayed. And you couldn't call it theft, cause the time I lost I gave. And it's certainly nice to know that I can go. And it's certainly nice to know that I can go.
Thank you so much. Oh. Go Democrats.
Ben and Sam, thank you so much. That was fantastic. I just feel like grabbing an inner tube and jumping on the Sacramento River and just floating all day listening to that song. That is fantastic. Ben and Sam, thank you so much for helping out. Your singing has helped raise our total to $2,500. We've had over 100 pledges so far. So please help them, keep them coming in. My next guest is the daughter of a Mexican immigrant, a community leader, a church youth group leader, and also the chair of the Butte County Democratic Party. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Lupita Arim-Law.
Hi, hello. Welcome to Butte County Democrats Tubing with the Democrats. This is a fundraiser to open Democratic campaign offices in Chico, Oroville, and Gridley. The campaign offices will help elect Democrats up and down the ticket, with the top slot being replacing the President of the United States. Hi, my name is Lupita Arim-Law, Chair for the Butte County Democratic Party. Thank you for joining us today. I hope you will enjoy the incredible music we have lined up for you. Also, hearing from local elected officials and community activists. Because of COVID-19 and the CDC's guidelines, we are unable to organize our traditional fundraiser, so we had to come out with a virtual option. Because this is the most important election of our lifetime. And that's in 5 months. So please press the button below and donate generously. The more we raise, the more we can do. If you've considered donating to a political campaign in the past and just haven't for one reason or another, this is now is the time. Enjoy the show and thank you.
Thank you, Lupita. Our next guest is a longtime labor leader, an attorney, a lieutenant in the U.S. Naval Reserve, and the chair of the California Democratic Party. I'm very pleased to welcome to this studio Rusty Hicks.
It is great to be with Butte County Democrats this evening. I know that we are separated by many miles, but I know that we are together in spirit and in collaboration and in action. And obviously this is a great event, and I'm so incredibly proud of the pivot that we have all collectively made in order to meet this moment. Because we've got a lot of incredible work to do. We're doing so much important work today. Obviously, great work that's happening right here in Butte County. Obviously, at this moment, many of us are in the streets, making our voices heard, ensuring that we change our country once and for all. But it is important. While it's important what we do today, it's important what we do in 2 weeks and 2 months. And certainly in 5 months, when we take our democracy back. Yes, that includes winning here in California on the local level, keeping the House, taking back the U.S. Senate, and yes, removing 45 from the White House once and for all. And so I'm so incredibly proud of what you're doing in Butte County. So incredibly proud of what California Democrats are doing, not only in California, but all across the country. So incredibly proud of your work that you are doing and the work that you will do. So it's so great to be here with you this afternoon. Encourage you all, if you've contributed once, great. Thank you. Contribute again and again and again until it hurts. If it doesn't hurt, you haven't given enough. And so I just want to thank you all for being here. Congratulations to everyone, and look forward to working with you in the coming months. Take care, everybody.
Thank you so much, Rusty. Inspiring words. Thank you very, very much. Just want to let you know, our phone lines are open. We're waiting for some phone calls. That's 530-255-4089. We've got some wonderfully welcoming people that would love to talk to you and help make that donation. Our following guest, our next guest, taught guitar at Chico State and is renowned for his transporting classical guitar. I'd love to welcome Warren Haskell.
Hello. This piece is called Chilean Dance by Andrew York. Thank you.
Thank you, Warren. That was fantastic. It was beautiful.
Thank you.
Now, we've heard a lot about the role that big money plays in the political process. When big donors and when corporations give money to people in their campaigns, that's who they listen to when they're in office, and that's not good for people like you and me. But here in Butte County, nearly all of the campaigns are financed by individual donors, just like you and me. And so that's important when these people get elected, because that's who they listen to. They listen to you. And so please give. Right now, we're at $2,900. And hopefully in the next few minutes, we're going to get that up over to $3,000. And this is money coming from you. This is money coming from me. This is not money coming from oil. This is not money coming from big pharmaceuticals. This is coming from us. And that's who our politicians are going to listen to. And that's who our politicians are representing here on the local level. Politicians such as the next person who is with us, our next guest, one of the youngest council members in the history of Chico, a social justice advocate and a social worker, and the city's top vote winner in the 2018 election. Absolutely my pleasure to welcome here Chico Vice Mayor Alex Brown.
Thank you so much for having me, and thank you all for tuning in and supporting this amazing cause. Hey, folks, this is Alex Brown. I am absolutely honored to be the vice mayor of the city of Chico. And there are a ton of urgent and complex issues facing our communities right now. But I wanted to take my time to talk to you about an issue that feels pretty straightforward. In 2016, the voters of Chico voted in favor of a safe, regulated, legal, and local access to cannabis. For over a year now, the city council has worked to craft an ordinance that's been informed of hours of public input, committee work, and council deliberation. That ordinance was set to be approved the night the COVID-19 emergency was declared in our community, and obviously for good reason. But especially at a time when residents in Chico are losing their jobs and our economy is facing devastation due to COVID-19, a local, well-regulated, legal, and robust cannabis industry will create an economic infusion and hundreds of jobs that we desperately need. Every month we put off this final approval inches us closer to the November election. And if businesses don't get up and running, we face losing all of the progress that we've made to enact a reasonable and informed policy. It's time to honor the will of the voters and to elect and support people in office that are going to see this effort through for our economy, for safe and legal access, and to make room for the kind of progress and the kind of innovation that makes Chico such a beautiful place to be. The Butte County Democratic Party is here to support those leaders that are going to fight for progress. So please click the link and donate today. Thank you for being here, and thanks for everyone who is supporting this effort.
Thank you so much, Alex. Great words. Now, someone that we expect to see also serving on the Chico City Council very soon, Planning Commission member, community leader, and 7th District Chico Council candidate, Rich Ober.
Hey, everyone. It's really great to be with you all today as we do this work together to advance the causes that we all care so much about as Democrats. My name is Rich Ober, and I'm running for Chico City Council to represent District 7. Which includes some of the most historic and historically disenfranchised neighborhoods in Chico. I've been lucky enough to live in District 7 for all 26 years. I've been a proud Chicoan. I've lived in the Mulberry neighborhood, in Chapman, in Barber, and now our house in the East Streets. I care deeply about this district, and I'm eager to focus my time on the council on issues of economic, environmental, and social justice. As a truly progressive city council member, I will advocate tirelessly for community policing best practices, including mandatory implicit bias training, de-escalation training, and accountability through city community oversight. These are really hard issues, but they are more important to tackle right now than ever before, as many of us are in the streets peacefully advocating for change. I know, though, that with your help, we can get this hard work done together. So my name, yes, is Rich Ober, and I look forward to working with you all after joining the council in November. Be sure to click on that Act Blue link below and enjoy the rest of the day. It's been great to be with you.
Thank you very much, Rich. Yeah, I want to reiterate what Rich just said about that Act Blue button that you see down there. It's absolutely safe. It's absolutely secure. You can donate any denomination that you would like to. Any, if you want to do $20, if you want to do $30, whatever it is, you can donate that. Doesn't have to be a lot, but just give. Give a little bit more. Any little bit helps. So that button right down there, you can click it at any time and donate. We're already up to over $3,100, and we want to get that number up before the end of this afternoon. So next, I'd like to introduce to you a musician who's made his name in Butte County and beyond. And you can check him out at ilovekylewilliams.com. And so please welcome, you guessed it, Kyle Williams. Thank you, Kyle. That is the kind of passion that we need to take with us into the November elections. And that is the kind of passion that you folks are showing today. We're at $3,900 right now. We're so close to breaking that $4,000 barrier. Click that button and make that happen soon. Our next guest has made it her mission to inspire all eligible voters to make change in the North State. She's a farmer, she's an activist, and she is also our candidate for the 1st Assembly District, Elizabeth Betancourt.
Good afternoon, Butte County Democrats. It is great to be part of this event. What a technologically advanced event. So thank you for letting me be here with you today. I am just really inspired by the work you've done in Butte County. We are part of building a movement, and our on-the-ground local organizers are essential to that effort. So thank you for the work you've done in getting progressive voices in city council, county supervisors, and really helping us to fund the state level and federal level campaigns as well. So local organizing is essential in driving voter turnout and in ethically funding campaigns. So I'd encourage you, to the extent that you are able, please donate what you can to the DCC. They help us immensely in running our campaigns on the state and federal levels. So thank you for your help. Thank you for being here this afternoon, and enjoy the weekend. Bye.
Thank you very much, Elizabeth. You know, one of the big issues here in the North State now, on all of Butte County, in Chico and in Oroville, is homelessness, affordable housing for everyone. And the next person that's going to speak has been a big advocate for the homeless and for affordable housing throughout Butte County. She's a founding member of Save Oroville Trees and a member of the Oroville City Council. I'd like to welcome you, Linda Draper.
Good afternoon. It's wonderful to be involved with this project. I would just like to thank you for what you're doing. It's so important. Senator Bernie Sanders has said that for the last 40 years, we've had an affordable housing crisis in this country, and that it's only gotten worse. And here in Butte County, we know this is definitely true, as we see the numbers of homeless people increasing and others who are struggling. There's a study that was done recently by Harvard University that shows that 38 million families in this country are having a horribly hard time paying for housing. They're paying 50% of their income, when they should be paying no more than 30% for it to be considered affordable. Now, the worst of it is that the ones most impacted are handicapped people and senior citizens. Then we know that the situation has been exacerbated by the high costs of rents and housing, stagnant wages, and lots of natural disasters that we have had in Butte County, as well as the pandemic. These are all contributing factors to make the housing situation here even worse. We really need more elected progressives in this county to address the issue of affordable housing, as well as other issues that are crucial to all of us. If you'd like to donate, be sure to click on the link that says Act Blue at the bottom of your screen. Thank you.
The next song renews our collective memories of November 8th, 2018, a day that none of us here in Butte County will ever forget. Our members who lived up in the Foothill communities awoke to smoke and flames. Now, this next musician, he and his wife, they made a harrowing escape from that community in separate cars. They never knew if they would see each other again. And he's turned that experience into this song that he'd like to share with you right now. So I'd like to welcome Mark McKinnon.
Hi, everyone. She was dreaming of the fire that night. Moaning sadly by my side. While I listened to the banshee wind howl and scream at paradise. A tsunami wall of smoke eclipse the rising sun. Swallowed the blood red, early morning sky. Just like that, we were a town of refugees. We were running for our lives. We barely breathe. World came undone. Breathe for everything we love. Breathe as the flames blinded our sight. Breathe and pray we'd see the light and just breathe. We watched our paradise burn down to the ground. Her trees explode like thunder in the air. And so many brave hearts and sweet dreams were shattered like the broken glass everywhere. And I'll never forget the moment I watched her disappear into the thick black smoke as she drove through the fiery gates of hell. Oh, she called me on the phone and said, I need to tell you this just one more time. Baby, I love you. Ooh, I love you. I couldn't breathe. Oh, she was my only one. I couldn't breathe. It's her love that lifts me up. Breathe. As flames blinded my sight, I couldn't breathe. I prayed she'd see the light. Baby, just breathe. When I saw my love again safely on the other side, I called out to angels everywhere. Oh, please, please bring your saving grace to those souls left behind, lost in the smoky air. Now we're wandering tribal orphans on strange uncharted roads, looking back at the ashes we once called home. We're still calling on our angels to help us all remember. None of us are traveling alone. We're not alone. And to help us breathe. Breathe with our only ones. Breathe. Oh, the love that lifts us up. Help us breathe. And dream gently through the night. Help us breathe. See the morning light. Help us breathe. Help us breathe. Oh, help us breathe. Just breathe.
you, everyone, for all of your hard work.
Wow, Mark, thank you. That was quite moving. And that's something it brings to mind. That's a local musician turning a local incident into something that all of us locally can recall, all of us locally experienced, and something that was important to all of us. Thank you again, Mark. That was great. We're at our halfway mark. We're at 250 pledges. Thank you so much. That is fantastic. We're at $4,900. We're so close to $5,000. We want to get there in the next few minutes. So thank you again, everyone. 250 pledges is amazing. That is fantastic. So up next, joining us from her home in Sonoma County, please welcome to the chair of the Rural Caucus of the California Democratic Party, Joy Sterling.
Good afternoon, Butte County. Thank you so much for including me in this incredible program. Mark, what a great song, very moving and so poignant because we're going to be facing fire season very soon now, and we need to be prepared and remember how important it is for us to have unity at this time. I have been so impressed this week at your activism in Butte County. This is just tremendous. Congratulations. Please go ahead while I'm on the air, hit that 5,000 mark.
Educator,
the Rural Caucus is a resource. Please use us when you need us. We're here for you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Joy. Thank you so much. You know, a lot of people think making donations is for somebody else. Making donations, well, that's what rich people do. But there's a lot of Democrats throughout this country showing that viable, important campaigns can happen on just a small donation platform of making individual donations. We've seen that happen on a national level, serious candidates and serious platforms. Few candidates in North State history have inspired people like our next guest here. The political process has opened up tremendously because of people like Audrey Denney.
Hello, Butte County Democrats. I'm so excited to be here with you virtually this afternoon. And first, I just wanted to say a huge thank you, because the people watching this live cast are the folks that have I think I'm on still. Huge thank you to everyone who's watching, because you folks are the folks that shaped me into the candidate that I have been able to be for the last 32 months. And that's somebody who is going to win the seat in November and be the first Democrat elected to the House to serve our district since 1974. But even more important than that victory is the work that's been going on locally since long before I joined the scene. Folks, that's the grassroots organizing that you've been doing, right? The organizing that you are doing is the organizing that is building the infrastructure, building the base that will last for many, many generations to come. And that could not be more important. So almost always I'm asking for donations for my campaign. I probably ask you at least once a week, probably more towards the end of the quarter. But tonight I'm asking you to dig deep to support the amazing work of the Butte County Democrats, because they literally cannot do it without folks like you, and their job is to build that base and to make sure we'll be successful for a long time. So thanks so much for having me. It's been great.
Thank you so much, Audrey. And yes, she's absolutely right. It's those donations that come in that help candidates like Audrey represent us and represent Northern California, not just locally, not just in Sacramento, but nationally as well. But we're sending her from the local party here. Thank you very much, Audrey. Our next musical guest began singing as a child in church when her grandparents and her great-grandparents served as ministers in North Carolina. Please welcome Lady Love, Francés Mann.
Just like that river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long, long time coming, But I know the change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there way, way beyond the sky. It's been a long, long time coming, and I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me, please. But then he winds up knocking me down, right down on my knees. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it is. There's been times when I thought I couldn't last for long. But now I know I'm able to carry on. It's been a long, long time coming. And I know a change is gonna come. Oh, there's been times that I thought I couldn't last for long. But now I think I'm able to carry on. It's been a long time coming, and I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Blessings.
Francis, thank you so much. That was absolutely beautiful. It was stirring. It was moving as well. You know, a lot of people out there are probably saying, I don't know about giving money. I can't give much money. Well, you know, the heart of the community out here is also volunteerism. Everyone here today is volunteering their time. All of the musicians are volunteering their time. I'm volunteering my time because it's a cause that I believe in and a cause that I want to see go forward. So if you see someone that moves you in some way, if you see a candidate that is speaking to you, please don't hesitate to call up and say, hey, how can I help? How can I volunteer my time? I'll guarantee you, they will not turn you away. They'll not say no. So please, volunteer. If you want to help us by donating, that's what we're here for today. You can donate by clicking that Act Blue button. If you don't want to click the button, go ahead and call us at 530-255-4089. We're past the $5,000 mark. Thank you so much. We're over 400 pledges today, which is phenomenal. Thank you so much for everything that's happening. So we want to press on. We want to go forward. Next, we're pleased we have a young activist who's helping to challenge and energize the Democratic Party in so many new ways, the best of ways, from the Sunrise Movement. I want to welcome Stephen Marquardt.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Stephen Marquardt. I'm a 25-year-old organizer with Sunrise Movement based in Chico. Young people like me have seen war and climate chaos, racial injustice, gun violence, and so much more for most of our lives. The establishment politicians have failed us. Too many of those before us have let us down. I'm only here today on this call because I know that the only chance that we have at creating a world that is just and equitable, one where Black lives matter, where healthcare and housing are secured for everybody, where climate change is treated like the crisis that it truly is if young people are leading the way. It'll be tough for Democrats to win without the youth vote. So the party must start to reflect our values and our vision for the future. And I appreciate the Butte County Democrats for uplifting the work of young organizers on the ground all over this county. And I want to encourage you all to make sure that you donate to the party so they can keep doing the good work. It's this generational solidarity is what it's going to take to make sure that young people can transition into the leaders of the future. So thank you all for tuning in, and thank you for having me.
And those words are true. It's never too early to get involved. The Democratic Party relies on the energy of the youth movement as well. Volunteer, donate, and vote. That's all you have to do. Make this country, make this community your own, and shape it in your own image. Those words were fantastic. Thank you again, Stephen, very much. Next up, I want to welcome someone a lot of you know, a singer-songwriter, multiple Blues Award winner, a published author, a Butte County business owner, and someone that you've all seen at some venue or another throughout the years, Maurice Big Mo Huffman.
Got a long, long way through me, and I find it in there. All I need, coming home, ain't going out. Hey, Lord, I'm on the run, hiding her. Holding up, come down to stay. Been making a little law since 1969. Man on the moon, they got my mama make me a fried bologna sandwich, huh? Who are we?
Bet. Thank you so much. You know, we talk a lot today, Chico and Oroville, it gets a lot of the press. You know, we talk about Chico, we talk about Oroville, we talk about Paradise. But so much of the energy of the Democratic Party comes from some of the smaller communities. Gridley is one of those towns that's been an absolute solid backer of the Democratic Party. And our next speaker hails from Gridley, son of a farm worker himself, beloved leader of the town. I'd like to welcome Angel Calderon. Angel. All right, we'll get back to Angel soon because he has some important words to share with us. We're going to go next to a musical duo I've had the absolute pleasure to see so many times myself. Every time I see them, I enjoy them, I love them, and I can't wait to see them again. I'd like to introduce to you some of my favorite musicians in town, Sunday Iris. Sunday Iris isn't on. All right. We'll just go right down the list. We'll get back to Angel. We'll get back to Sunday Iris as well. And let's see. Our next speaker after that on the schedule has been involved in politics since college. When she was a child, she did a clinical defense in Buffalo, New York. 500 Operation Rescue members were arrested, and they kept the clinics open. And that's the kind of activism that we love to see and the kind that we're seeing happening right now. So please welcome 3rd District Supervisor Tammy Ritter. We don't have Tammy either. Well, I remember a monologue I knew from Richard III, but I'm not going to get into that just yet. Since we saw a rendition of Richard III play out in our nation's capital just a few days ago, when this country's leader held a Bible in his hand, a book that he doesn't read, in front of a building that he doesn't go into. It's straight out of Shakespeare from what's going on. But what we want to talk about now is donation and how that's important, how every dollar that you give in to us today is going to stay here in Butte County. Because the thing is, it's these positions in the city council, the county supervisor, and the state assembly, they're the ones that are closest to us here. And they're the ones that mean the most to us. They're the ones that shape our communities, the lives, and they most closely and most directly impact what's going on with us here in the North State, with what's here in Chico now. And so that's what's important for us and why it's so desperately important to click that button and to donate now. Because that's the thing, I touched upon this earlier, and it's something that is important to all of us as we're in a time right now, you know, where we're concerned about where this country is going, where this county, where this city is going. I have kids and I worry about what is the world that we're delivering to them and where are they going on? And the way that we can shape that, the way that we can help that is through activism and through helping out the local party and by voting, by getting those people who are intelligent.
I can't see anything except the
who are clear, and by getting those people who are compassionate into the offices nationally and in the state and in the city as well. And so please, please donate and help us get that word out. All this money that's coming in today is going to fund the headquarters in Oroville, going to fund the headquarters in Chico to help these local elections and help get these people with our mindset and the issues that are important to you into offices. And so we have someone with us who you've already heard from in one aspect, one of our favorite local politicians. You heard her speak as a politician. Now you're going to hear her as a musician with a song for us is Alex Brown. Alex, thank you.
Thank you for having me again. You know, one of the things that feels so important to me as a musician. Sorry, there's some folks talking. I'm having a hard time. Can you mute yourselves? All right, folks. Well, this is Alex Brown again. And one of the things that I care a ton about in this community and love about the city of Chico and the county of Butte is all of the musical talent and the amazing art that it has to offer. And Democrats are the supporters of local arts. And so I'm dedicating this part of my segment to the local arts and I encourage you to donate via the Act Blue link so that we can continue to fight and support local art and public art. So I'm going to sing a love song, as is my style, not just because I love love songs, but because I love Butte County and I love Democrats. And so here it goes. This is a mashup. I've just seen a face, I can't forget the time or place where we just met. She's just a girl for me, and I want all the world to see we've met. Na, 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 na. Had it been another day, I might have looked the other way, and I'd have never been aware. But as it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Die, 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 die. Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. I have
eyes, I'll dream of her tonight. Die, 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 die. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you? Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling me back again. Falling, yes, I am falling, falling in love with you.
Don't forget to donate, folks.
Thank you, Alex. That was great. Thank you so much. And just a reminder, everyone, we're live, and live means excitement. And I'm excited to tell you, we have had over 2,000 pledges today. Hopefully you heard that, Alex. That's because of you. 2,000 pledges. Over $5,000 has been raised for the Butte County Democratic Party, and that is fantastic. So we're going to backtrack just a little bit. Like I said, we're live. We missed a few folks. We're going to fill them in for you. So we have for you now, I'd like to welcome the 3rd District Supervisor, Tammy Ritter.
Hi, thanks so much, Joe. Well, I really appreciate the invitation to be here. Butte County Democrats, one of my favorite groups. What I want to talk about today is I want to talk about the relationship that we have with our local jurisdictions. So between cities and counties, it's so important that we maintain and get majorities on city councils in Butte County, because working together with the cities and the counties is how we are going to make change. And so these upcoming races really are critical. Right now, we are seeing some activity in our country that we have never seen before. And I really think that we are ripe for change. We are ready. And I want to personally ask every elected official in Butte County to sign the mayor's pledge that Obama put out, asking us for police reform, asking us to review our policies and to look at de-escalation techniques. This is something that we have needed in the city of Chico for a very long time. Your local behavioral health advisory board supports this. We want to see every officer in Butte County trained for 40 hours of incident training, of critical incident training. So I want to encourage every single elected official, every single Democrat out there to please sign that pledge. And then I want to also ask you to donate to the Butte County Democrats today. And this is my son Gideon, and he has a message for you as well.
Please donate to the link below to help get Trump out of office.
Excellent. All right. So we have so many talented Democrats, and I'm going to offer a big threat here right now. Press the link below or I start singing. I'm not kidding. 99 bottles of beer on the wall.
Tammy, thank you so much. And yes, people have been clicking the link. Thank you so much, Tammy. And your words are absolutely right, and they do ring true. So many issues that are local issues. If police reform is something that's important to you, because it's something that's in the news every moment of every day within the last week, we've been hearing about it. Police reform is a local issue. Police communities are local communities, and they're operated and controlled on a local level. And so if that is something that's important to you, if that's something that you want to have a voice for, then you need to elect officials at a local level that will help institute police reform. If that's something that is important to you, now's the time to do it. Tracking back again, I talked about how the Gridley community is so important in Butte County, and it's been a strong bastion of the Democratic Party for so long. And someone who's a wonderful community leader and a leader of the Democratic forces there from Gridley is Angel Calderon.
Hi, everybody. My name is Angel Calderon, and I'm from the great city of Gridley. I have a very firm opinion as to the present political situation. I strongly feel that the Republican Party has lost its legal and moral authority to continue governing this country. I believe that it's time to bring dignity and respect to American institutions. So please, I urge you to vote Democrat on the next elections. Amigos, creo firmemente en el partido, que el Partido Republicano ha perdido toda autoridad moral y legal. Por eso mismo estamos pidiendo que usted vote por el Partido Demócrata en las siguientes elecciones para así devolver la dignidad y el respeto a nuestras instituciones y nuestro país. Es muy importante para usted. Espero lo haga. So thank you very much for this space. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Angel. Muchas gracias. Some of my favorite performers here in Chico, who I've seen many, many times, and I look forward to seeing many, many times again. Some of my absolute favorites, been following them for years. Sunday Iris.
Hello. I'm going to do an original song for you. It's called Where I Belong.
Minnesota, Oklahoma, down to Texas, up to California. This is where I belong. This is where I belong. I have journeyed far across the earth. Thank you.
peace, everybody. Lisa, donate below. Dave,
thank you. Thank you. Yes, peace to you as well. You guys open the skies up with your singing. I don't know if it's raining where you are, but I'm down in South Chico right now, and it's thunder and it's raining. I can hardly hear anything that's going on, but the songs are fantastic. And listen, talk about opening up the skies. You have opened up the skies. We are almost at $6,000, right? $5,800 right now. We're so close to $6,000. We've got about 20 minutes left, and we certainly want you to help us make that mark. So across the region, the Democratic Party candidates are running a campaign on a state level as well. And so next up is our third Assembly District candidate, Jim Henson.
Doing a pitch.
Hey, Jim, are you on? We're listening to you.
Hey, everybody. My name is Jim Henson, and I'm running for the Assembly District 3, and boy, I wish I could say that my legs are tired, but unfortunately with this virus that we have, I get to sit around and get to speak to you here virtually. So I want to introduce my friend Bill Monroe. He's helping out as we work together on this campaign, and I'd like to say welcome. Now, there's some concern that I have with education. Some concern I have for education, and I want to share that with you. Education to me is one of the cornerstones of our republic. And what that means is that California used to be number one, but now California has dropped to 38 out of 50 states. That is an abomination that I feel we must change and turn straight back. So I hear that there's going to be 100 initiatives that will be voted on in the assembly this session tonight. And I want to be that person to vote for that can be there, that will be supporting each and every one of you with that vote. Now, why don't you go ahead and contribute like I did to the Butte County Democrats so that we can all join in together and make this a great day. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim, and thank you for your generous donation as well during this broadcast. You too can be like Jim and donate. Only a few minutes left. We're at $6,300 right now. We've had over 2,300 pledges, which is fantastic. And as you've all seen, this is a live broadcast. There have been some miscues along the way. And what we do is we see how do we plan for these miscues. You can't plan for the unexpected because it's unexpected. But the unexpected happens, and you have to see how you perform during those times. And we've come through, we're back on track. But we've seen in this country recently, we've seen even locally, when the unexpected happens. This county was ravaged by an awful wildfire a year and a half ago. A few months ago, a pandemic ripped throughout the country. Now we're seeing in this last week, this country is being torn apart by racial tensions and violence, and it's really exposing what the leadership is in this country and where the holes are in this leadership because of what happens during times of stress and during times of turmoil. And that's why it is so important for us to put these people who are compassionate, who are caring, who care about you, into the offices so that when something happens like this, that we have the leadership to drive us forward in this. So, thank you very much for everything you've done. I want to welcome back here. I think I hear them in the background. Wonderful, wonderful performers. They played for you earlier. They're going to play once again, coming back to us. It's Cat and Coot of the Mystic Roots. Welcome back, guys. How you doing, Cat and Coot of the Mystic Roots? Cat and Coot Dog, are you on?
Coot, can you hear us?
Hey, Cat, Coot, are you there?
I think we are on live. Are. Hi, it's Coot Dog again with Mystic Roots, Dana Wyman, Coot Wyman. This is Catherine.
Hi.
And we're very proud to be here to support the Butte Dems. Please click the link below, Act Blue, help us get some funds raised. We can get some great candidates in office this November. Very, very excited. We have another song to play for you right now. The song is called Lonely Road. Catherine and I wrote this about the struggle and the journey, whether or not it pertains to musicians or just our citizens or our society as a whole. It can be a lonely road, but through perseverance, we can keep moving strong and stay at it if we work together. So here goes. Dreams I set way before I was grown. It's in my bones, my bloodline, father and son, my pop that did before me, and my kids will when I'm done. My pen is stronger than a gun, and it cuts like a knife. I'm making music for all these people who can't relate to my life. Pain and strife and happiness all balanced together. Same situations, different locations, a challenge forever. But you could say never will I retire, expire, rather just change up my style and take it much higher. Since I was passing out flyers, I touch this mic and it's just like I'm blowing gas on the fire. I follow the code, so I'm never truly alone. I got my family surrounding me out here on the road. Some promoters are cold, the glitter ain't always gold. New city, new people, new evils, new temptations. That's why I know what I know.
I ain't never gonna let this go. It's been too long now,
but I'm keeping it strong.
I gotta keep on pushing on. My story must be told.
Like 365 on the grind.
So I keep myself out on the road. far away from home. Still doing it on my own. Maybe someday I will feel so alone. That's why I know. That's why I know what I know. Never gonna let this go. It's been too long now. But I'm keeping it strong. Gotta keep on pushing on. Must tell it must be like 365 on the run. So I keep myself out on the road. Far away from home. Still doing it on my own. Maybe someday I'll be so alone. Hello. That's why I know.
Thank you guys so much. Please donate. Act Blue, the link below. Butte Dems. We're going to see some positive changes this election. We thanks for having us. Mr. Groot signing off.
Absolutely. Thank you. Hey, I'm digging your flow. You're bringing in the dough. And hey, did you know we're at $7,200? So we want to see how close we can get, how high that will go in just the next few minutes. We got about 12 minutes left. And I want to bring in another guest, someone who wants to speak to you. Someone has some very important words for you. He's a local environmentalist, and he's also a member of the Chico City Council. I'd like to welcome Scott Huber. Hey, Scott, can you hear me? Scott, you're on. How are you doing?
Thank you. This is Chico City Councilman Scott Huber here. I'm seeking your support in what is perhaps the most critical time in our region's history. Democratic councilors are being besieged as never before for standing up for our core values. As you know, years of wealth inequality and a failure to address the needs of the underprivileged, mentally ill, and addicted have led to a burgeoning population of citizens without housing. Myself and your fellow Democratic, fellow city councilors have battled opposition to assure that unhoused people are provided extreme weather shelter. We've been sued for our support of a tiny house village for homeless seniors, and we continue to work tirelessly on shelter and housing options. By clicking on the Act Blue button at the bottom of your screen, you'll help assure that our city council stays blue and is guided by leaders who care equally for all citizens, not only those with money and power. Thank you for being part of a 2020 blue wave.
Thank you so much, Scott, and thank you for joining us very much. Have a good afternoon and a dry afternoon. Now, we're going to welcome back one more time. You heard them earlier with a wonderful song, and you're going to hear them again with another wonderful song. Ben and Samantha, you know them as the Bidwells.
Thank you again, Joe. We are so excited to still be just supporting. We'd love to see all the positive enforcement and support that our community is giving. Once again, please donate if you have the means to Act Blue, the button down below. And thank you so much for watching and supporting.
Recently, Samantha and I have been out and about town delivering singing telegrams on front porches and lawns. And we've been sent out by folks around town who want to send a positive and loving message to their friends and family. And we thought that we'd play a song that's been requested quite a bit. We thought it was fitting being as we wanna, during this time, just express that in these isolating times that everyone has
allies and friends right now.
Yeah, and especially to our friends in the Black and Indigenous communities and the people of color, we wanna let them know that they have allies and friends here in Butte County.
So, we hope you enjoy this.
This is You've Got a Friend by Carole King.
When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care and nothing is going right, your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest nights. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there. Yes, I will. You got a friend.
If the sky above you grows dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your head together and call my name out loud. Soon you'll hear me knocking upon your door.
You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there. Yes, I will. Now, ain't it good to know that you've got a friend? When people can be so cold, they'll hurt you, yes, and desert you. They'll take your soul if you let them. But don't you let them. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you've got to do is call, and I'll be there. Yes, I will. You got a friend. You got a friend. Ain't it good to know you got a friend? You got a friend.
Thank you so much.
Oh. Ben and Sam, thank you so much as well. And yes, you do have a friend. I've been friends of theirs for a long time, and they are dear friends. So, folks, we have a few minutes left. There are a couple things I want to talk about. We're getting so close to our goal. We're at $8,700, and we have a few minutes left. And it's important to note in times like this, you know, when we see the local talent and we see the people that talk about local issues, and that's what this is all about. It's about local people making a difference locally, about building a community. And it's when the artists get together. It's when the leaders get together to talk about those issues that you want to hear about. That is what creates community. And that's something that we need right now more than ever. Seriously, we do. We talk about, and it's kind of a cliche, you know, a cliche, this next election is important. And every election is important, absolutely. But the thing is, this next election is important. It is so important, and we see that now. It is put out in relief in such stark contrast that we can see we can't let things slip any farther away from what the real American values are and what the values of this community are as well. And so now is the time to help us get the word out and to help shape the community that we really want to live in, to help shape the community that we want to be a part of and that we want to shape. And you can do that by electing the leaders that care about you, by electing the leaders that are beholden to you, not beholden to oil companies, not beholden to pharmaceutical companies, but beholden to the people that they're actually leading and beholden to the community that they're a part of. And that's where you come, and to be a part of this community as well. And that's how you're a part of this community, is by helping everyone out. When you elect good leaders, you help all of your neighbors in a wonderful and beautiful way. So please, in these last few minutes, take a few minutes and donate some money. And just donate maybe a little bit more. So you can, not just for you, not just for your kids, but for your neighbors as well, because that is what community is all about. And so I just want to say, let's get up to $10,000. We are so close. We have a few minutes left. I want to introduce you now to someone who is very special to a lot of people in the community, and a lot of people know her very well. She wears so many hats in this community. She is an educator, she's a radio host, and she is a filmmaker. I want to welcome here Sue Hildebrand.
Thank you, Joe. This is amazing. I was listening to your words, and they resonate with a lot of Democrats out there. I have to just pause and say, wow, we have so many creative people in our midst. I mean, it's the musicians, they are out there expressing the emotion, which is absolutely worth living for. But everybody that contributed today is a visionary as well. We are an amazingly creative group of people. And the reason that I say that is because the sun just came out. This is wonderful. The reason that I say that is because as Democrats, we can imagine things that are better. We can imagine things that are different. We can imagine, for example, healthcare for all. We can imagine affordable housing. We can imagine fair police practices. We can imagine a better future, a brighter future for all of us. And so it is just heartwarming to see all of the people on this program today, as well as all of the people that contributed, because we as Democrats are visionaries. And so it's just wonderful to join together with all of you. I want to give you a quick update. We have raised over $7,000. That's just from what Arim has told me, and he's only doing the Act Blue. I don't know what's coming in on the phones. We have well over 100 people that contributed today. And, you know, one of the things that I want to mention is that the reason that we're raising money today is because we need to raise the money to open headquarters up for Chico and Oroville candidates, because there's a lot of folks in the streets right now protesting for very good reasons. But without the power in public office, protesting is one half. Protesting is the idea of we can imagine a better, brighter future. To actually have power means that we can manifest those changes. And so it's just so heartwarming. It's exciting. Sometimes we all feel alone, that we are out here in the middle, you know, trying to do good work. We're out in the middle of nowhere. But to see this outpouring of support by the visionaries that all call ourselves Democrats, it's absolutely heartwarming. And you know that we're doing the right work, because as we wrap this up, the sun is coming out. It almost rained on us today and it didn't. So from the bottom of my heart, I thank everyone that contributed today, everyone that watched. I want to thank all of the musicians, all of the creatives among us, all of the politicians, all of the candidates, all of the people that made this happen, as well as Michael Branton, who pulled this off with the deep help of Chris Smith of Rocket Spots, and David Welsh and Steve Swim, and of course you, Joe Hilsee. Thank you so much for making this such an amazing event, and I hope we have many more of them to come. Pandemic or no pandemic, Democrats must win in November. So thank you to everyone out there, and I'm throwing it back to you, Joe.
And I'm catching it right from you, Sue. Thank you so much for helping us out. Great, great message. I want to bring on one final musical guest. I want to tell you real quick, we're getting very close to our goal. You have a few more minutes to help us make that live goal of $10,000. We're over the $9,000 mark, so we're getting very close. Our next musical guest, our final musical guest, a very special person in this times of shelter at home. A lot of the musicians that you see here, they haven't been going out to make their regular gigs. They've been having to stay. That thing that they do, they cannot do. And so Glenn has been at home in his studio, and he's been writing about this experience and what that's about. And so he wants to share with you a song that he calls Shelter in Place. This is Glenn Tucker.
And maybe take a ride, but no, gonna chop it on pain. It's the thing to do, chop it on pain. Do we get through?
Gotta wash my hands about a million times. Gonna write some new songs and find some new rhymes.
Gonna chop it and paint. It's the thing to do. Chop it and paint. Do we get through?
Something to do, strum some guitar chords, it'll help you get through.
Thank you so much, Glenn. That was fantastic. That was brilliant. Thank you so much. That was exciting. And the only thing more exciting than that, or it's not even more exciting, but it's just as exciting. It's exciting in a different way. We did it. $10,100 during the live telethon, which is fantastic. Thank you so much, everyone, for this wonderful cause and for being a vital and important part of it and the thing itself. So this is just the kickoff. We're just getting things started. Now, when everything is okay, when everything's in the clear, when we can go back out into the public, we're going to go back out into the public again, and we're going to do the most important thing that we can do, and that is to win the election, all of the elections down the board, in November. And that's what this is. Everyone who donated has become a part of that. And when that happens, you'll be able to say, I helped make that happen. So thank you. Congratulate yourself as well. And all those other people who donated today. Now, for those of you that haven't done it, if you're watching this on YouTube, hit that subscribe button down there. And anytime there's word about upcoming events or anything, you'll be able to get that on the YouTube channel. It's very easy. They won't take your email or anything like that. You're just subscribed to the channel. If you're on Facebook, like the Butte County Democrats business page. Likewise, you'll get on their feed, and that way you'll get word of anything that's coming up with events or anything like that. So stay connected and hear what's going on and stay together as a community. Now more than any other time when we have all these challenges, it's very important to utilize the technology that we have to us to help get the word out, to help stay connected as a community. And that's the important word here, is community. And thank you all so much for creating that community. And thank you for creating a community that we can all live in, and that we can live in peacefully and happily and cheerfully. Thank you so much. Again, I'm Joe Hilsee. It has been my absolute pleasure to have all of these wonderful guests here, the talent and the minds and the passion that's been at work here. And I want to thank you so much for donating, for your talent and minds and passion and your dollars as well. Now, this is going to be up here. There's going to be links. This has been recorded, so you can share this with your friends. They can donate as well, people that have like minds and like passions as well. So again, for everyone, for all of us who are part of this, thank you. Thank you, and we'll see you soon. Bye.